We begin with the Sardar Sarovar alternative delivery mechanisms. The present status of the Sardar Sarovar is that out of about 48,000 kilometers of planned submariners, only 10,000 kilometers have been constructed. So in this scenario, what is the fastest way of achieving an increase in the irrigated area? Now, according to a new policy introduced by the SSNNN, it has been decided that the Irrigation Cooperative Society would decide, depending upon the land gradient and the technical and geographical aspects of the area, whether to go for an open channel gravity system or an underground pipeline system. And it is in this context that we examine four pipeline system models. And what lessons do we learn from these alternate underground pipeline system models? Which is the most cost efficient way of achieving an increase in the irrigated area in the command? Which is the most efficient way? Which model provides maximum water control? Which is the easiest way in terms of implementation? And which is the most sustainable model in terms of water logging and salinity? Very quickly, we start with the original plan of the Sardar Sarovar project, where it had been decided that the SSNNL would construct the main canal, the branch canal and the distributary, and the irrigators would contribute land and other resources in construction of the subminers. But this has not happened because the farmers have refused to part with their land, and instead what has emerged is a chaotic model. We can see here that the farmers have invested in pumps and pipelines on their own, and they are lifting water from even the main canal and the branch canal to transport the water to irrigate their fields. As I mentioned earlier, the Sardar Sarovar has a new policy of an underground pipeline system being allowed, and it is in this context that we examine four different underground pipeline systems. The first is the Rajasthan Narmada Canal model. The second is a gravity-based pipeline system, which is the Kiamuni Irrigation Project in Kenya. The third is a model of 26,000 overhead towers. I'll describe the model in detail later. And the fourth is the Krishna Lift Irrigation Scheme. A description of the four models. The Rajasthan Narmada Canal model. The government transports water from the distribution system and the minor canals to the diggies, and from the diggies up to 8 hectare area via underground pipelines, from where the farmers have to access it using drip and sprinkler methods of irrigation. The second one is a gravity based pipeline system, which is government constructed and does not use pumping. In this context, one example is the Kiamuni Irrigation Project in Kenya, where we have main pipes on both sides of the river, and the farmers access the main pipes. Once the water reaches the fields, the farmers use drip and sprinkler method for irrigation. The third model was also a model that was suggested for the Sardar Sarovar project, where we have 26,000 overhead chambers and 26,000 pumps running over for these chambers in order to transport water via underground pipelines to the fields. Each chamber is of a capacity of 8 lakh liters. The fourth model is the Krishna Lift Irrigation, where the farmers themselves have formed groups among themselves and they have invested capital, and they have formed their own lift irrigation onto the streams, and all the government has to do is provide water permits to these farmers. We now compare the four models in terms of different evaluation parameters. Beginning with the Rajasthan Narmada Canal project, the capital cost is around ₹2400 crore in addition to a subsidy on drip and sprinkler irrigation. In terms of water use efficiency, there are two contrasting effects. First is that since drip and sprinkler irrigation is compulsory, we have water use efficiency to that extent. But since we also have the presence of diggies, there are some evaporation losses that occur. Now, water control is defined by two things. One is the temporal variation in the adequacy and the timeliness of water supply. And the second is the predictability, which is the extent to which the irrigation can be forecast. And both these conditions are satisfied because of the presence of diggies. So in terms of water control, Rajasthan Narmada has a high degree of, it seems to display a high degree of quality control. In terms of ease of implementation, politically it's been feasible because the farmers are not opposed to parting with their land. They have accepted the value that's given to them under the Land Acquisition Act. And in terms of sustainability, there are measures in the project in terms of water logging and salinity. They have reduced the water allowance and they are promoting conjunctive use of surface water and groundwater in order to check the rise in the groundwater level. We come to the second gravity-based pipeline system wherein in terms of the operating cost, it seems to display a high degree of efficiency because there are no pumping costs here, it's based on gravity. The 26,000 class model seems to be the least efficient because in terms of the capital cost and the operating cost, it scores low. In fact, according to one estimate, the power consumption will cost Rs. 250 crore per year in this model. And it's not, apparently not easy. And in terms of the Krishna Lift Irrigation Scheme, the capital cost of the government is almost nil. It has to incur the administration cost of providing water permits to the farmers. Operating costs are nil because again the repair and the maintenance are the responsibility of the groups of farmers who have procured the permits from the government. In terms of water use efficiency, they do promote drip and sprinkler irrigation by freeing up around additional 14% of the reservoir fringe area to the farmers for issuing permits for lift irrigation. In terms of water control, the farmer again has absolute freedom as to when to apply water to his field because the lift irrigation is owned by him. And in terms of physical investment, it seems to be an easy model to implement. Now, I have discussed these several parameters of evaluation and one can assign different weights to these different parameters of evaluation, and I'm sure all of you have a different opinion about which model is the way to go for the Sardar Sarovar project. But I personally believe that if we want the fastest way to achieve an increase in the irrigated area in the Kaman with the least physical cost of investment, I would go for the Krishna Lift Irrigation Scheme. Thank you.